So the reason I'm here is to take some samples of the corn because I want to draw the corn. And I'm going to be setting up still lives with the corn. And that means that I need several stalks. Listen to the sound of the wind in the corn. Let's just take a look. There's a tall stalk, the pollen that's at the top. And then you can see that the corn cobs, which are big seed pods, are down about a third of the way up the stalk. So I want to go into the corn to take my samples. Your best samples aren't on the absolute edge. But I don't want to go in and make a mess, knock things down, act like a raccoon stealing corn. So I'm going to use a waterway to access the corn. Because we're in hills, there's a lot of runoff, and the waterways give me great access to the corn. You can see that there's paths that the deer take into the corn. It's another way that you can actually go in. It's a little closer and tighter, though. Like, obviously here, some critters have been feasting on the corn. It's right there. For me, planning a drawing is always linked to an experience. And usually the experience is the experience of gathering this specimen that I'm going to use so that I can really be inspired and have the plant right there with me. I love to draw seed pods. They are incredible. And you can save them. And so you don't have to draw them before they wilt, like with so many flowers. And let's take a good look at these buttons. You'll see why I really love them. I think these are going to make a beautiful drawing. There's just a great architecture there. And people like abstractions. This kind of a drawing will be very abstract. And because not many people are actually aware of this particular kind of weed, they may not even know what they're looking at. They may just see a beautiful design. Here, by the way, is the waterway. That's where we're gonna go. That's where we'll access the corn. That is actually a native foxtail, kind of a beautiful feathery plant. I haven't drawn the foxtail yet, but I think I will in the next year or so. It hasn't been high up on my list of priorities, but it is definitely something that would make a really nice drawing. So let's go into the waterway. Just gonna hold the camera while we walk in. This extends for quite a while. This field goes right up this hill in this valley between these two ridges. And you can see the foxtail here. These are gloves that we use for our organic gardening. It's called Atlas. It's strong and very protective, but it's thin. And you can actually feel pretty well through these gloves, because with so much of our gardening, we need to be able to feel and touch what it is we're growing. This is raffia. I like to have some raffia with me because I like to use it to tie things up, make bundles of things. This is just a camera. It's a digital camera. It's about 8 megabytes. I've been using it for a long time. And I like to take reference photos because even though I'm taking samples, the way things look when it grows is always different. These are 2 cutting implements. This is a really nice clipper. you don't want to fight with the plant or with the stalk if you're taking samples. You don't want to pull on it. You want to be able to just get a nice, good sample. And I like this one. This is a saw that if I need to saw at something, I can. So with these two tools, I'll be able to take some nice samples. I want some corn that hasn't been opened. It's okay to have some corn that is, as long as there's lots of corn on it. You can see it's really beautiful in here. It's very peaceful. And the distance between the stems is not so much that I can't kind of wiggle in there, step through that space and get to a deeper space without causing too much damage. When you're gathering samples, you just don't want to damage the plants. You want to leave behind the plants that are still there without them having been traumatized. You don't want to put stress on them by going in. You want to be very careful. And so what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to step between these two that are about a foot apart to get back to that next set. And I'll be able to walk along that line because these corn is in rows, so I can walk along that line. And from being in there, I can pick different plants. What I'm going to be looking for is I'm going to be looking for different configurations of the corn on the stem. And I'm going to try to be sure that I get at least one that still has the pollinating apparatus at the top, because they don't all have that. For a lot of them, those have gone, but I want to get a nice sample of that. I think that'll make a beautiful drawing. And I'm also going to take some photos, still photos, to use as reference. Even though I'm taking several stalks, I want to be sure that I have a good sense of what it looks like when it's growing like this in the field. So I'm going to turn this off and start to work, and then I'll be able to show you later what I collected. Okay, so I'm back. I've done all my collecting. As you can see, I have a little bit of raffia left. I always like to have a little bit in my pocket, because when I'm coming back from collecting, you never know what you're going to see. So I don't use it all up if I can help it. As you can see, I decided to go ahead and get those foxtails. I collected them in two ways. Here I just, these were pretty nice large ones. They've dropped most of their seeds, but there are still some seeds inside. And I thought, as I studied them, that I might just want to be able to stick these into a still life to make it fuller. These are ones that I selected mostly because I wanted to get the leaves and how they grow up along the stalk, what their configuration is. They're really very graceful, the way they fall away from the stalk. You can see right here, I've tied these together, but they're not even at the bottom. And the reason that is because these tend to get stuck to each other, and getting them apart can lead them to break off. And so what I did is I staggered them up this one branch so that as I take them off, I'll be able to remove the lower one and then the next one, and then still have the ones at the top. And that should protect them. I also noticed that those that are here in the waterway are not as dusty as the ones that were over near where the gardens are, because the tractors stir up a lot of dust in the gardens. And so that made them, I think, a much better specimen. Because they are fuzzy, they still have that fuzziness. They're not a sleek, shiny pod. they'll make much better drawings. Down here, I have the corn. You can see that it's just beautiful the way you can access a plant like this when it's not 6 feet or 8 feet in the air. I put them together in ways that protect it, I hope. The way the corn cob drapes away from the stalk, we can really see that corn right there. And we can also see the ones that did not develop. Stalks can develop two corns, but the second corn is usually smaller. And it's really better if all of the energy for the plant goes to the first one. So this is what I've collected on this day. And now I'm going to carry it down to the building in the distance, which is a shed for Iowana Farm. And I'm going to store those there until I get my car prepared to be able to take these home.